This is if it's night back at it again with another news video. So right now I'm looking at the listing for the Bandai Arbalest 160 of skill version IV. Of course IV stands for Invisible Victory, which is the new Full Metal Panic series that's gonna come out. A chronological order of the series would be Full Metal Panic, Full Metal Panic Fumofu, which is the comedy series, which is pretty awesome. You should check it out. And it also comes the third season comes out as the second raid, which is the third season. Then the fourth season is this guy, the Invisible Factory Ivy. So as you can see from this guy. Okay, actually, before all that, I'm actually making this video because I don't normally see a lot of news coming out for the Bandai Arbalest or any other figure from the IV, the Full Metal Panic IV, line at all. Maybe I didn't check it out, or maybe I didn't catch it at the Hoppiling TV. maybe I didn't see it. Facebook, maybe I didn't check on it. Kinda hard actually for me to do it, but yeah, let's do a quick slideshow. Okay, if you notice that in this picture, the Arbalest is holding a new type of weapon. I think it's a machine gun looking type, and also if you notice, this guy is really detailed. There's a lot of recessed area, there's a lot of dots, a lot of details. This is something Bandai should be pushing for any other model kit in the future. The name of the rifle or the new weapon should be the Grass or Grace Manlicher. I think this is the LDW type. I'm basing this knowledge off of the details section of the listing, so you can go to Army, check it out and see for yourself. Next. What I've noticed on this guy is that number one, new weapons, number two, more details, number three, if you look at this, it really looks like it uses double joints, and that's important because it could show that the articulation is going up, it's getting better. And especially for Bandai has been notoriously known for making pretty crap kits from other series other than than Gundam, their flagship model kit line. So if that is the case and it's not just really bad body caps, then I'm pretty much hyped for this model kit. Right, next. As you can see, it has a very convincing kneeling pose, really good articulation for the knees, and I'm assuming really good articulation for the knees. And this is a very solid, convincing pose that the Arbalest is making. Another pose, weapons, monomolecular cutter, the lambda driver. This cutter shot is also a bit different because it uses a magazine or a clip system. And the only other robot or mecha that uses the clip system with the scatter shot that I think of is the Libertine. I think that's how you pronounce its name, and as you can see, it uses a magazine system. So yeah, the lambda driver parts, yeah, pretty much very very standard issue. More pictures of the lambda driver. Seems I'm not showing one of the right here. So over here it looks like it shows like there's a drop down leg mechanism that allows the Arbalest to kick very high up. And as you can see, look what it has there, and I believe this is pretty much a good segue to this guy. Yes, the guns back for the Curse Weber and or the normal version, and also the Melissa Mao version of the Gurren's back is gonna come out in this Bandai line. Just to let you know, this line is gonna be in 1/60th scale, so I think it may be too small, maybe too big, I don't know, but I'm gonna be I'll just leave that later. So as you can see, pretty cool poses, pretty cool poses, very detailed as well. Look at that. As you can see, the shoulder pieces are different. Alright, compared to the Robert Damashi, it has less details. The Robert Damashi has less details, but the model kit seems to have more details. And as you can see, there's a new type of weapon, and I think that's the Grazmanlicher. And I have to look down to see what version it is. It's the battle rifle type. So yeah, pretty cool looking figure. Yes, as you can see right here. And you have the standard issue stuff for the thing for Melissa Mao. And next, for the Curse Weber, or the normal version of the gun's back, it looks really detailed. And this is gonna be the one they're gonna be pre-ordering. I already pre-ordered this figure. The figure is gonna be released on April 2018. So yeah, really good looking figure. As you can see here, and now it's standard issue stuff for the gun's back, the 40mm. This should be the assault carbine type for the Curse gun's back, and you have the sniper rifle. Okay, so just a little recap. Bandai is releasing new model kits for the Full Metal Panic Invisible Victory series, and I'm pretty much hoping for less stickers, because when I see in the details section that there are 4 stickers that's gonna be provided, and I'm pretty scared of that, because Bandai has been notorious for giving a whole lot of stickers for details for model kits lines outside of the Gundam series. So yeah, I'm very hyped for this. I already pre-ordered the Gun's Bad Curse Weber version, and yeah, I'm pretty much on the fence for pre-ordering the other two versions. So, but the weapons and the details and everything looks really cool. So I'm pretty much hyped for this line of figures, and I'm hoping for enemy figures like the Shadow, the Kodarl, the Savages. Well, the Savage is gonna be cool, because it's a very grunt type, and I like grunt suits. So yeah, thank you for watching, and have a nice day.